In this video, we are going to be discussing another application of systems of equations known as polynomial curve fitting, okay? Now, what is polynomial curve fitting? Well, basically, this is what Excel does when we, quote, add a trend line through data, okay? So basically, in Excel, if you recall, when we add a trend line through some data points on a plot, you can display that equation on the chart, right? And you can see the equation that models that data that you have put the trend line through. So how is it working? How is Excel fitting that trend line through the data, and then how is it coming up with that equation it's displaying? Well, this is how we're gonna show what Excel does kind of behind the scenes, okay? So let's go ahead and get started. Suppose we want to fit a polynomial function through a set of data points. Okay, so if we have n number of data points, we can fit a polynomial of degree n minus 1 through these. Okay, so what does that mean? That means that if you have, say, 3 data points, you can fit a polynomial of second degree through those 3 data points. If you have a polynomial of 5, if you have a data of 5 data points, you can fit a fourth order polynomial through those data points. So the degree of the polynomial that you can fit through a number of data points is always 1 lower than the number of data points you have. Okay, so we can say, for example, for 2 data points, we can fit a polynomial of order 1. Well, what's a polynomial of order 1? This is a linear equation. Okay, and so you would say f of x, you would set up the general form f of x equals ax plus b, where a and b are coefficients, okay? What about for 3 data points? Well, this would be a polynomial of order what? Pause the video because I'm about to tell you. Polynomial of order 2, okay? This is a quadratic equation. And so you would use the general form f of x equals what? Pause the video if you think you know it. F of x equals ax squared plus bx plus c. Okay? What about for maybe 4 data points? This would be a polynomial of order what? 3, right? It's 1, the order is 1 less than the number of data points you have. What would this be? This is a cubic equation. What's the general form of a cubic equation? Well, you would have f of x equals ax cubed plus bx squared plus cx plus d, okay? And then we would say so on, okay? so on. So let me ask you this. What would be the general form of a fourth order polynomial? If you had five data points and you wanted the general form of a fourth order polynomial, well, of course, you would say f of x equals ax to the fourth plus bx cubed plus cx squared plus dx plus e. So you keep adding on that additional level of polynomial term, the higher the polynomial goes, okay? So you have to think about that, okay? You have to know how to do that and think about that. So let's jump right into a simple example in this video, okay? Let's look at a simple example here. Here's what I want us to do. I want us to fit a polynomial function through the two data points. Okay, and here are our data points, 0, 1 and 2, 3. Okay, so this is all of our given information. All right, so under solution, what do we know? Well, we have two data points, so we use a first degree polynomial, which is a linear function, okay? Since we have two data points, we use a polynomial that has an order one less than the number of data points we have, okay? So the general form, right? The general form for a linear function is actually it's really slope-intercept form, but we'll just say it's general ax plus b, okay? And what do we have here? Well, remember x is our independent variable. F of x is our dependent variable. And a and b are constants, okay? Now, again, think about what we're doing. Think about what we're doing. We're trying to determine what this function is, okay? So make a note here so you don't get kind of lost in this, okay? What are we doing? We are determining what this function is. So what does that mean? Well, I mean, you may say, well, it's f of x equals ax plus b. Well, we gotta be more specific. We are, say dot, 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 we are determining a and b, okay? We are determining a and b. So how do we do this? Well, we are given two points, right? We're given 0, 1 and 2, 3. So watch this. What we do is we substitute the data points into the general function form, okay? So let's do it one at a time, okay? For the data point 0, 1, what do we have? Well, we have f of x equals ax plus b, so we're gonna have 1 equals a times 0 plus b, right? As x, when the x value is 0, the y value or the f of x value is 1. So that's one of our equations, okay? What about the next equation? We have the equation 2, 3. So when f of x is 3, what is x equal to? 2, right? And then we have plus b. And so what do we have here? We have a system of two equations with two unknown quantities, right? Let's say this is a system of two equations with two unknowns. And what are the two unknowns? Well, they're the values of A and B. Now, if you look at this system, this is a pretty simple one, okay? This is a this one is not really mind-blowing at all. So the first equation really just becomes B equals 1, right? Because you have 0 times A, so B equals 1. And then the second equation, of course, you can write it as 2A plus B equals 3, but you know B equals 1, so from the first equation. So what does A equal? Well, you say 2A plus 1 equals 3, so 2A equals 2, A also equals 1. So you don't stop here, okay? Finally, the equation of the first degree polynomial is f of x equals what? X plus 1. And that's what you would box in with a straight edge, okay? How do I know that? Well, again, we solved for a, and so we remember we have f of x equals ax plus b. So we have 1, a is 1, 1x plus b. B is also 1 right here. So on these problems, the solution, what you're trying to find, is the equation of the polynomial, okay? So if you box in a equals 1, b equals 1, that's not the end of it, okay? You're going to lose points. That's not the end of the story. The end of it is finally writing this equation, okay? So that's going to conclude this example, and we're going to have another video with another example right after this.